What's going on, everyone? Thank you so much for watching today. My name is Savannah, and today we're back in our franchise zoo, which is Tolly Zoo, and we are going to add the meerkat today. I'm very excited about today's episode. I actually did a whole bunch of off-camera work in preparation for this. So in last episode, if you did miss it, we went ahead and added another little viewing area to our Indian elephant enclosure. And we did some work on our front entrance area. I think it looks a whole lot better. But what I did off camera, or part of what I did, is deal with these annoying little turd of an animal because they were escaping left, right, and center, and I literally couldn't unpause the game for more than like 2 seconds, otherwise they were halfway across the zoo. So I figured it out. They were somehow morphing out of this wall and like climbing this fence stuff. So I moved it way far away. It's kind of why it's hanging over because I haven't like 100% fixed it yet. But they're not escaping for the time being, which is nice because that was more than annoying. So I did that. We also got some new Babarusa because one of our Babarusa did unfortunately inbreed, so we have a baby. One of these babies is an inbred one. Ooh, but this is the new one. This is the one that's not inbred. Look at those genes, and it's a gold one. Oh, that's fantastic. So that one we will definitely be keeping. Look at how cute they are. Little wrinkly guys. I know we've looked at them before, but they're so cute. And we have two of them. So we did that. We got two new females and sent everybody else to the wild. Unfortunately, a few of our animals have passed away. We lost our black jaguar, so we don't have that anymore. We lost a couple of our aardvark, so we actually have a new girl in here. We have a male and a female in here. And actually, I don't think I labeled. I'm so bad at remembering to label these, you guys. It helps so much to label them, but only if I remember to actually do it. Another baby hippo. My goodness, aren't we lucky today? We're gonna get another little baby hippo. So while we do that, let me tell you about what else I fixed. I completely redid our work zones. So now each of here, I'll speed it up because she's gotta come out of the water to have her baby. Each of the work zones are completely redone. I have separated them into either one or two habitats in pairs, and each exhibit work zone has just the habitat as well as a staff zone or staff center, staff building, staff center. Look at the baby. And a keeper hut. So that is all nice and finished. We have a little boy here with a bronze. Not bad, not bad. That's so exciting. Having so many, oh my gosh, and ring-tailed lemur. Why do I feel like they're gonna explode? And the next problem with the ring-tailed lemurs is gonna be that we have like a gajillion of them. Anyway, back to the work zones. Sorry guys, I'm a bit all over the place today. I actually recorded this and then annoyingly finished recording it, went to shut off the recording, and it wasn't recording. My favorite thing. So I'm having to go back through this with you guys. So apologies if I feel like I've said something or I skip something or I say it again because I'm not quite sure what I have or haven't said yet. But yeah, so we have all new work zones. So you can see here, they're all nice and beautifully labeled. Not only did I do the habitat work zones, but I did a couple education work zones and a couple vet work zones as well. The caretakers, the mechanics, and the vendors are all just free to roam about. I didn't put them in a work zone, but the education work zones that I did is one for the Indian elephant, one for the Aldabra giant tortoise, and you can see here these guys are nice and labeled and all set and ready to go. They have their educator, so they should be good. And then education zone 2 is actually the jaguar, the clouded leopard, and the caiman, because I felt like we needed to try to pull people over here. We might make use of those vista points to get people over here because it's kind of empty over here. But anyway, I did that. I want to add more education, so I figured we'd just do maybe like a flamingo lemur one or a flamingo otter lemur one. That way we can assign another educator to that one. Oh, good night. Nighttime. And yeah, so that's pretty much what we've done. I also, speaking of, with this research that popped up, made sure to start researching the North Africa theme right away so that we can utilize those pieces because I'm so excited for them. So excited for them. But yeah, like I mentioned in the beginning of the episode, I want to add our little lemur, not a lemur, my goodness, I can't get them off my mind, meerkat habitat here so that we can have our cute little meerkat friends and then possibly our fennec fox over here, just two kind of very small habitats because I love how little space they actually need. If we go into here and we click meerkat, we can see this one right here. They only need 180 square meters for just one of them there. And I love it. So we can add some nice small habitats. This one right here, as of right now, is 632. So that's even a lot of room. So we have plenty of room to make a back facade and surround it so that their actual traversable area is the right size. So I'm super excited about that. More vet research going on here. Let's see, more ring-tailed lemurs. Great. I feel like the vet research is just flying by. I also did do a round of training for our staff. So I went ahead. Ooh, I can do it again. I went ahead and trained the staff that I was able to because I want them to work more efficiently so they can get their jobs done a little bit better. And I also, ooh, you're fully trained. I can't train you anymore. You guys had suggested something else. Oh, I hired three more caretakers as well because there was a lot of trash everywhere. So I hired three more and hopefully they'll be cleaning that all up. I totally forget. There was one other thing that I did and now it is, it's escaping me. So what I'm gonna do is I am going to sit here and wait for it to be sunny again. And then we are going to jump right in to our time lapse and get our little meerkats. I'm so excited. So let's get to it. So I have to say, I'm already a little nervous. I'm already a little worried. We get our meerkats in today. I'm very excited about them. However, they are very popular with the public and our guests are swarming and flocking and they're already starting to seem a little bit stressed and I'm having PTSD. I'm having flashbacks of our jaguar and our lemurs. I know it's not really flashbacks because it's like currently happening. It didn't happen in the past, but I'm a little worried about it. I don't want our meerkats to be so stressed out because I really am happy with how their enclosure comes out. I think it fits the space perfectly, and at least I tried. You guys can let me know if I succeeded, but I tried really hard to make it look like it fit in with Tali Zoo. Like, I didn't want it to stick out like a sore thumb, right? I didn't want it to just all of a sudden be like, bam, overly Africanized themed habitat in the middle of our tropical zoo. I wanted it to be like, look like it was for the meerkats, incorporating some of the new styles, things like that. But, you know, I actually don't think, other than the plaster like pillars, I really don't think I used any of the new building pieces yet because I really wanted this to, like I said, look like it belonged in Tali Zoo. I didn't want it to just not mesh with everything else. So I really am happy with how it comes out and I don't want to change it. So I am worried. Hopefully it will be okay. I know we did get some one-sided glass pieces as well, so we might have to utilize those just to make it so that they're not upset. I do try to utilize the vista points in this episode after we're all done to put those down to see if I can't like attract guests in different locations, but we'll see how it works. I did put down the like be quiet, don't disturb the animal little sign thingies. So we'll see if that works. The only thing that I didn't do is put the ambient speaker noise thingies like you guys have suggested before. So if it still doesn't work next episode, we might try those. But overall, I'm very happy with how this comes out. I'm very happy that we have the meerkats in. We end up getting four little guys and They're so cute, and I'm having so much fun with the Africa Pack. I want to know, what are you guys enjoying about the Africa Pack so far? Or have you even gotten it yet? What's your favorite part? All that. I just want to know what the feedback is. From what I can see, there is a lot of overwhelmingly positive feedback around the Africa Pack. So that makes me very happy to see. But let me know. I mean, there could be people that aren't happy with it. And, you know, I only see what I see online. So let me know down below and then we can talk about it. But utilizing for the fence pieces for the first time, our new chain link fence pieces. Very excited about those. Those came in the free update 1.6, so you don't have to purchase the Africa Pack for those. And I was super, super excited that they brought those to the pack. I'm sure that I've talked about it before. You guys have already heard me say it, but I am just that excited about chain link, about fence pieces. So this habitat comes out just to being a very natural habitat. It only took me probably an hour and a half or so to get this time lapse done. Really not that bad. I really like this little house that I made them. It's kind of like a little mud house. Oh, I did utilize the painted wood pieces. That is the other Africa piece that I used from the new pack. So they're those painted logs. They have like paint on either end and they're recolorable so you can change the color of them. These ones right here. Really like these. These are going to be really versatile and useful in a lot of different builds. But utilizing just to make this little kind of African inspired little like mud hut thing as their shelter. They do get to go in this, so their traversable area. I'm actually very pleased with what they can walk around on because they're such small animals. So they can get in there. We do put bedding down in there. They do go in and lay down and have a nap. And I think that it's perfect because it's a nice, you know, small little area. We don't have to make an incredibly enormous house for them. I do utilize those pots on the outside. Like if this were a real life zoo, right? I imagine that tipped over one that they would like to go in and explore in. They can't do that in the game, but that was my idea. Utilizing some of the new foliage pieces as well. I love, love, love that grass we got. I think it's beautiful. I think it's a really good detailing piece to give some grass in different locations in the habitat. Excuse me. And then what is it called? It's a type of palm tree. But I really like that one. And I also like sinking that one down because if you sink that one down, it almost looks like another type of grass when you sink that down. So I'm really happy with that because I really like the color. It's a really nice bright green color, but like a savanna color, like you would see out on the desert, right? In the savannas. So I really like that color of the tree as well. And then I do pull some trees elsewhere from in the zoo to kind of make a backdrop for this habitat, kind of fill in the space between this one and the Indian elephant enclosure, because there is kind of a little bit of a gap there in between. So I figured that might just be a space for plants, right? Because it's not going to be an easy space for keepers and maintenance workers and stuff to get to, so it's probably just going to be rocks and foliage. I will say I did struggle at first with how the heck I was going to finish off the front of the habitat. So I did the plaster backdrop first, as you guys just saw, but then I kept looking at the front and I actually paused the recording and stared at it for quite a while and just couldn't decide what kind of fence, what kind of wall, what kind of barrier I wanted to put up. So I went with my go-to. I went with rocks. You can't go wrong with rocks, right? The more rocks, the better. We'll just keep adding them until we can't anymore. But I did decide to leave that little viewing area on the right-hand side open. So that's obviously when you're coming back around from the Indian elephants, you can kind of stop and get a view of the meerkats from over there. So those are the two different viewing areas for the habitat. And I do end up throwing a vista point over there because when we do hit play, I noticed that all of the guests went front and center. They went right to the middle of the habitat, which is no surprise because, you know, that's the main viewing area for the habitat. But I wanted to kind of try to spread them out a little bit so that way hopefully we can keep them from getting too incredibly stressed. I don't know. We'll see if it works. But just adding some detail around here with those aquatic rocks, the aquatic rocks that we got in the aquatic pack, and adding a little bit of detail, a little bit of planting around. You know, I didn't want to do the double fence so that we can keep people off the glass. I do remember to add education, so yay me. We end up adding a education talk point as well as an education board, as well as donation bins, so I didn't forget that. So good job me for remembering that I'm playing in franchise. I've been playing in sandbox mode for the last week and playing a lot of sandbox to do my speed builds and things like that. So I had to remind myself that this is franchise and we care about the animal welfare and, you know, how the game plays and stuff like that. So just reminding myself that that actually does matter in this. But we are nearing the very end of the time lapse. So just throwing in the very last minute little details. I think I work on like a little barrier next. Oh, that's right. Pulling this over just to make the back end of this look a little bit more finished so that it's not just a blank space. So adding a door so it looks like the keeper can actually get through and it's not just, you know, walking through a wall. And then I end up adding like a little rock wall because I like to do this. I feel like it adds a little bit of realism where we take some rocks or a wall or some sort of scenery object and we kind of just try to hide slash disguise the keeper entrance a little bit. But that's really it. So we're going to go ahead and add one more tree, apparently, and then jump back into the real time very shortly. So I'll meet you back in just a second. All right, so nice, quick, and easy time lapse. We have our little meerkat habitat. Let's go ahead before I forget, because then if we don't do this, I'm gonna be wondering why the keepers are not helping them out. Let's go ahead and add a new work zone here, and we'll just say meerkat zone here. Perfect. So now we just need to get ourselves a keeper for them. We'll plop him down right there. And make sure we are paying the right wage here. Come here, let me make sure. Thank you very much. And then we need to assign you to our meerkat work zone. Perfect. So now that that is all addressed, I want to very quickly, because I did put down a talk. So let's go to the education zone one right here and go ahead and add this one. Oop, not that, that to it. Perfect. So then this will be we need to put the animal in first. Okay, so we'll go get the animal first. So let's take a look and see what kind of little meerkats, or which meerkats rather, are on the workshop that we can adopt. And I'm pretty sure, I'll double check. Wow, goodness gracious. Let's click on you and go to the Zoopedia first because I do want to double check. I'm pretty sure they can be, 2 to 30. So we can have a lot of them. So let's go ahead, maybe let's just start with 4. Let's start with 4. So we're not looking for the best ones, remember. You'll do, so that's a male. How about, you're pretty terrible as well. Let's go ahead and get you. And then maybe another male. Let's go for you. And then I think we will adopt her. Okay, so that was pretty easy. So that is 4 little meerkat friends. Let's go ahead and just send them to the zoo. I'm too eager. I don't want to wait for them to do the quarantine. So I'm going to hit play and have that go. Let's go ahead and adjust this education then to make sure we show off the... Oh, they're not in there yet. I'm so impatient. I just want them to be there. Speed up time. Make sure they get over here. Ooh, Aardvark is already expecting offspring. That's super exciting. Here they come. Our little meerkats. Okay, so now slow down. Let's go ahead and... that's going to have to get fixed, huh? Uh-oh. All right, let's assign them to meerkat there. I'll pause it real quick because it looks like they're clipping through my little rock wall. Assign that to meerkat. Let's go ahead and put this in November. Great. And then let's just go ahead and move this real quick. This was honestly just kind of like one of those blockades because I like the look of, you know, so the guests can't see where the keepers enter. Like if you're looking from over here, it gives a little bit of a hidden area. But if it's going to make the the meerkats freak out. We're not going to be able to do that. Let me see here. How do I click on this habitat? We might just have to hit... oh, there we go. Unbox all animals. So did that work? Let's unbox you because you seem to have a problem. There we go. All right. Oh, look, they're already running with their little tails up. That's my favorite animation. Them running across with their tails up. I think it's so cute. Oh, no. We have a flamingo that's passed away. Oh, why'd you have to pass away like in the foraging pond? While they're eating. Couldn't you just walked right over here? Oh, I'm so sorry. Okay, back to our meerkats. Ooh, where did my mouse go? Clicking on all sorts of random things. There we go. Okay, where did our little meerkats go? Here they are. Let's go ahead and just double check that they're nice and happy. Beautiful. Oh, look, and they're already digging. Oh, I'm so excited about that. What is going on? Oh my Lord. Why? Okay, I'm gonna ignore them for now. I don't have the patience. I don't have the patience. Oh, did we not? What? You are reaching it. You're literally going in and out of it. Okay, I'm gonna ignore that for now too because you just came in and out. Let's make sure. I don't think I actually put down a food thing for them. So let's go to, actually, okay, before we do that, let's get vet research going on them because they have some cool enrichment items that I want to use for them. But now let's go to habitat and then make sure that we select the species of meerkat to make sure that we can, there we go, we can get food and water for them. Let's do a little large tray. Let's go ahead and put this, we'll just put this right here. It'll fit right nice right there. Perfect. So now they have a little tray. That's awesome. Let me just, I'm curious what their traversable area is like in here. Oh, great. Okay, and they can use their little house. Perfect. Oh, I might not be able to ignore the lemurs. They're attracting protesters. Why are you guys so incredibly difficult? I regret my life decisions in putting you here. I'm pretty sure that was because of, yeah, it's just because of stress. Well, I know that we had the tortoises here first, and then we just redid this to do the lemurs. Maybe, to be honest, maybe we switch them out one more time and do something that is going to be really confident with the guests. Or, you know what, to be honest, maybe we try, because we have vista points, right? So maybe we try utilizing the vista points to have them spread out a bit, because, like, look, they're not over here. So will that even work? I wonder. Let's just try it out. Is it under guest facilities? No, it's media, right? Yeah, here's a vista point. So let's go ahead and put this right here. And then if we click on it, set item focus, facing direction. Yeah, habitat 28, confirm. Okay, so they'll come over here in view. And then if we duplicate that, and put one maybe over here. There we go, over there. Will that work by spreading them out a little bit, I wonder? Because there are a lot of people there. So if they are getting really stressed out about that, kind of don't blame them. Well, we'll let that run. We'll see what it does. Let's see, low welfare, why? Because you're space and stress. Ugh. We're gonna have to do an overview episode again just to handle our jaguar and our lemur, man. They are needy little animals, but that is not what I care about this episode. I care about our little lemurs. Ooh, we got more mechanic research. Not our lemurs. I said it again. Not lemurs. I care about our little meerkats because I'm super excited to have them in the game. Where is one? They're so small. They're kind of hard to find, actually. Here we go. Look! Oh, I'm so pleased with how these guys came out and how they look. They totally capture the mannerisms of meerkats and the way they walk around and the way they run with their little tail up. I cannot wait. The babies, when I was building the sandbox habitat that got released on the channel a few days ago, the babies are so incredibly cute because I got babies in that habitat and they are so fuzzy looking, so sweet looking. I love them. Look, here they come running across the enclosure. Oh, I'm so happy with these guys. Oh, let's not get in a rock there. Okay. So yeah, what else did I want to accomplish in this episode? That was pretty much it, to be honest. I just wanted to get our little meerkat friends in here, and I am pretty happy with how this area turned out. And hopefully they have little babies soon and we can see them. I did leave this little like viewing area over here, so maybe we utilize, yeah, let's put down another vista point over here too. Because I guarantee they're not going to view them from over here. Let's go ahead and set item focus and not that rock. No, thank you. How about this habitat would be great. There we go. You don't need to stand there just to view this rock. You can stand here and view this habitat. That would be awesome. Perfect. And then they can view from over there. They can view from over here. Hopefully these guys do not have the same... Uh-oh. We might have to turn this into one-way glass, because we can do that now, right? With the glass panel. Isn't it down here somewhere? Maybe. Or it's a different panel. I know we do have like one-way glass panels. We might have to look into that as well, just to give them some stress relief if they're gonna really be stressed. But, yeah. It doesn't seem to be too bad because at least they like run and go behind the rocks and things. These guys do have quite a bit of area to hide. Oh, we can actually, now that I'm thinking about it, because I always forget where security, these little signs, shh, do not scare my meerkats, please. You guys better be quiet and polite, because we do not want to scare our little meerkat friends. And while I'm thinking about it, our zoo's grown quite a bit, and I think we only have like one security guard. Oh, we have three. I'm gonna get two more just to make sure. You guys patrol the area. Please make everybody be quiet so they don't scare my meerkats, because I don't want to change the habitat. I'm really happy with how the habitat is. So wrapping up this episode, we've got the meerkats in. Next episode, I'm torn. Uh-oh, who died? Oh no, one of our otters. Why do they have to die in the water? And why do they have to die in such weird positions? Anyway, as I was saying, what I want to do is I want to continue expanding this area over here, but I want to add some more of the new animals. So let me know what you guys think down in the comments. I'm torn between the African penguin or the fennec fox. Now, I talked about maybe the fennec fox here, but we could also put the African penguin out this way, or we could actually put the African penguin back over here. Just kind of, I don't know, I feel like it might fit next to the otters and things. I don't know, let me know, but we'll handle this over here next time. We'll add another animal next time. I am just so, so happy. Where'd they go? I wanna watch them again. Here they are. I want to watch them again and watch them run around. Oh, look, they're standing on their hind legs. How cute are they? But yeah, guys, thank you so much for hanging out. Thank you so much for watching. Oh, he's like using his back to like prop himself up onto. That was really adorable. Really adorable. But thank you guys so much for hanging out. I do hope that you enjoyed this episode. I'm having so much fun with the new pack. I can't wait to film the next episode. To be honest, I might jump into it right now and just start recording. I won't start building because I want to hear your guys' opinions on what animal we should add next. But I'm having a lot of fun. So do let me know what animal, African penguin versus fennec fox, you think would be good. If you enjoyed the video, as always, it really helps out if you leave a like and subscribe if you want to keep up with what we've got going on. And I will talk at you guys in the next episode. Bye, guys.